guys, it is like sort of summer here in the Netherlands. It's like 23 degrees Celsius, which is really, really hot. And I'm wearing a dress for the first time in like forever. But look, there's like a cutout thingy. Yes. Hi guys, my name is Sabine and welcome to another video. On the 14th of April, I turned 19, so this is my last year as a teenager because next year I'm gonna be 20, which just sounds really strange and I feel like I should be more grown up than I kind of am. So yeah, I turned 19 on Saturday, the 14th of April, and on that same day, I went to Dublin with my mom because I really want to do a little city trip with my mom and I got to pick a city, and Dublin seemed like something that wouldn't be something that you would like instantly think of, but it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed Dublin and I would definitely like to go back another time in the future. Of course, I also needed to go to a couple of bookshops there and I picked up 5 books in a day. But my mom reminded me that because I turned 19, I will probably get some money from like grandparents and stuff like that. So I could buy a little bit of books. I went to a lot of bookstores, but I bought books at 2 different bookstores. First at Chapters, which I will leave the address somewhere here on the screen or in the description bar down below. And I also went to an Eason bookshop, and I've never heard of Eason. I don't know if it's like an Irish thing, but I loved the big YA section there. There were like so many YA books, whereas Chapters was also gigantic, but there were like only 4 or 5 shelves of YA, while at Eason there were about 7 or 8, maybe even more. So I will split my book haul in the 2 different bookstores that I went to. So first off, I will start with Chapters because that was the first bookstore that I went to. I bought 2 books there, very cheap. It was 5 and 6 euros per book. The first one that I have is The Hobbit by j.r.r. Tolkien, I think is how you pronounce his last name. This is a classic fantasy story. I have never watched the movie trilogy. I've never watched The Lord of the Rings, which is also by him, but I feel like I first should read The Hobbit because this is sort of like the backstory of this whole J.R.R. Tolkien world saga. I don't know how to call it. I truly don't know what the story is about, which is only just the better because everyone knows the story of The Hobbit except for me, I feel like. I know that the story of The Hobbit is a little bit more mild and easy to get into than the Lord of the Rings series, and I don't think I will ever read the Lord of the Rings. So Bilbo Baggins is a hobbit who enjoys a comfortable, unambitious life, rarely traveling further than the pantry of his hobbit hole in Bag End. But his contentment is disturbed when the wizard Gandalf, okay, I know that name for sure, and a company of 13 dwarves arrive on his doorstep one day to whisk him away on a journey there and back again. They have a plot to raid the treasure hoard of Smaug the Magnificent, a large and very dangerous dragon. I've also heard of the name Smaug, and that is because Benedict Cumberbatch plays this dragon in the movie. So I know a couple of facts about The Hobbit, but I've never read the story, and I truly think that I should. It's also not too big, so I hope that the writing will be fine. I mean, look at that, it was 5 euros, and I think it looks great, so I can't wait to pick this one up. Then I have more of like a modern classic fantasy story, and that is The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. I said Patrick? Patrick Rothfuss. This one was 6 euros, and it is a gigantic book. I believe this one has 650 pages, around that number. I think that this story is about a guy who pretty much tells his life story to us, and it's supposed to be full of fantasy, and I've heard only amazing things about this one, to be honest, so I hope that I will enjoy it just as much as everyone else. So those were the 2 books that I bought at Chapters, and then I bought 3 books at Eason. So let's start with the one that I'm currently reading because, oh my god, it brings back so many child memories, and that is Matilda by Roald Dahl. I have been meaning to buy Roald Dahl books in English for quite some time right now, and I told my mom if we find Matilda, which the chance was really quite big, I will get it because I've been meaning to read this book in English for such a long time. I think that I read it, ooh, just punched my camera, but I think that I read Matilda in Dutch for the first time about 10 years ago, and that's also the only time that I read it, and right now I'm like 1/3 of the way through, and oh, it's just so nice, and I love it so much in English as well. So if you have any other books by Roald Dahl which I should read, like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory and The Big Friendly Giant, the BFG, but also other stories, let me know in the comments down below because I want to read all of them because this one is so cute. Then there was this deal, buy one, get one half. Then there was this deal, which they also have at Waterstones in the UK a lot, which is buy one, get one half price. And then I can just not buy one book. I need to get two because half off, like, who can let that pass, people? So the first book that I bought with that deal is The Knife of Never Letting Go by Patrick Ness. And look at these pages. They are so pretty. This book is being turned, I think, into a movie pretty damn soon. I think maybe next year. And this is a special 10-year edition. They also had the second and the third one in this edition there. But I thought, let's read the first book first and then decide if I want to continue on with this trilogy. This is a dystopian trilogy, I believe, about a town or place where everyone can hear everyone else's thoughts all the time, but then our main character finds a place where it's just him and his thoughts only. And I think we follow the story from that point on. It sounds very interesting. I mean, this book is over 10 years old probably, so it's kind of like a YA classic, and I think it's just beautiful, so that's why I wanted to have it. The last book that I bought, which was also in the buy one get one half price deal, is The Exact Opposite of Okay by Laura Steven. And I have sort of heard of this one, I think, on BookTube a little bit, but it's not that popular. It has over 500 ratings on Goodreads. It is a contemporary, and after I bought it, I read this line and I was like, oh my god, this makes me even more like interested in picking this one up. And that line is, a novel for anyone who's ever called themselves a feminist and anyone who hasn't. And I just read Moxie this year, which is an awesome YA feminist novel. And I love that one so much. So after I read that little line, I was even more compelled and like wanting to pick this one up. Izzy never expected to be 18 and internationally reviled, I think is how you pronounce that word. But when photos involving her, a politician's son, and a garden bench emerge, the trolls set out to take her apart. Armed with best friend Ayita and a metric tons of nachos, she must figure out who's behind the vicious website while keeping her sanity intact. Izzy is about to find out that the way the world treats girls is not okay. It's the exact opposite of okay. So this just sounds like something I would enjoy. It came out, I think, in March, and I'm really excited to pick this one up soon. So those were all the 5 books that I picked up while I was in Dublin. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel somewhere here on the screen. You guys can also follow me on all of my different social media pages. Of course, I have Goodreads, Snapchat, Instagram, plus an email address, and links to those will be in the description bar down below as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!